Hey, Out Late But Great, this is Jim here from Ohio, and it is Friday, and I am your host on Fridays on the channel Out Late But Great. So anyway, guys, I'm just sitting out here enjoying the sunshine. I better soak up some because, as you all know, summer is coming to an end here in the north, and pretty soon there's going to be snow out here. So I thought I better come out here and just soak it up. So anyway, this is an open topic week, and I really wasn't quite sure of what to talk about, but something happened in the news yesterday that really, really made me mad. As you know, here in the United States, a lot of the marriage equality cases are going to federal courts because we have bans on them, just like the one we have here in Ohio. Well, first of all, most of the courts that have taken up the case have ruled in our favor. I mean, I would say 99.9% of them actually have. But yesterday in Louisiana, a judge, his last name was Feldman, actually ruled against us. He ruled that the state of Louisiana could discriminate against gay people and make sure that marriages don't happen. And if you read the words that he put out there, you really would want to throw up, because the reasons that he gave were, first of all, he said that homosexuality is a lifestyle choice, which, you know, we've heard that before. Gosh, did you guys choose to be gay if you're gay, or did you choose to be straight? I don't ever recall making that decision. So anyway, according to him, it is a lifestyle choice. And also, one of the other big factors for banning gay marriage is because children do better with a mother and a father. Now, first of all, to get married, you don't have to have kids. I have an older sister, and her husband, they never wanted kids. They're in their 60s now, so I don't think they're ever going to have kids, but they're married. And besides that, I mean, I know, as you all know, I have friends that are a same-sex couple that adopted children out of foster care and gave them a stable, loving life. So what does that mean? I mean, his words are just so false, number one, and old-fashioned. You know, he says that states can decide marriage laws. Well, if that's the case, then I think even in 2014 there still would be a ban on interracial marriages in the Deep South. You know, the courts really have to step in. They do, and they have to. That's why they're there. They are there to protect a small part of the population from being abused by the majority. And the funny thing is this guy is 80 years old. He's an old white southerner stuck in his own time zone in the 50s probably, and this is a person that's going to make a decision that's going to affect my life and all the people in the South and in Louisiana. I mean, it just doesn't make any sense. I really do think that there should be term limits for these judges. I mean, 80 years old, are you kidding me? And I don't want to get anybody mad at me for age discrimination, because my God, my Aunt Ruth died when she was 94, and she was all for gay marriage, and she liked my partner, or loved my partner more than I think she loved me. So I can't say that, but I mean, at age 80, I think you should retire to the golf course and just live your life and stop trying to put these antiquated views in society. So I don't know what's going to happen with all that. I really don't. I'm actually kind of nervous of it going to the Supreme Court, because there are those people on the Supreme Court as well. just hopefully common sense will rule, and we will have marriage equality in the United States. I mean, they have it in Canada, they have it in the UK, they have it in France, they have it in all these countries, and life is still going on. People are, heterosexual couples are still getting married and having children. Society is not unraveling, that is for sure. So anyway, guys, that's all I gotta say. Just make sure you vote. You know, if you live in the United States, we have elections coming up in November, and really research the people that are on your ballot and find out what they're all about, because that's really the only way we can change things. It really is. So anyway, guys, that's all I gotta say. Enjoy the sunshine, take care, love you, and I will talk to you next week. Bye-bye.